My name is Dr. Lolita Velita. My undergraduate course is in Bachelor of Science in Commerce, major in Accounting, and also my master's degree is in Master in Business Administration, and my doctorate degree is in Doctor in Business Administration. I belong in the College of Management and Entrepreneurship in Cebu Technological University main campus. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. For my career summary, including with my industry experience, I am actually an accomplished general management officer with experience in marketing and operations. I really practice a highly participative and team building management style with strong loyalty to company goals. I have my master's in business administration. I belong to the College of Management and Entrepreneurship in the main campus of Cebu Technological University. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Christy May Bibanco-Bastasa. I am a faculty of the College of Agriculture, Food Science, Business, and Communication in the Cebu Technological University Barili Campus. I am a faculty under the Agribusiness Program, and I earned my Master's of Management major in Business Management in Visayas State University with a Bachelor's degree of Agribusiness. Thank you.
I am Arlene R. Sala, currently in Naga Campus, which is located in the South. And I am a bachelor in commerce, major in accounting. Master of Arts in Education, major in social studies, and a doctor in development education. My experience when it comes to business engagement was 2 years in bookkeeping. Then I went to the academy.
I am Mr. Alvin Sisterba. I am a faculty member of the College of Management and Entrepreneurship of Cebu Technological University, main campus. I am a certified public accountant and a registered post accountant, and also the holders in bookkeeping NC3 and computer service NC2. I am a graduate of Master's in Management at the University of the Philippines Cebu, and also graduate from the Bachelor's in Science in Accountancy at University of San Jose Recoletos. So my field of expertise is focused on accounting, auditing, taxation, management, business, entrepreneurship, finance, human resource management, and business. So I've been in the industry for 14 years before I transferred to the academy. Thank you.
So good day, everyone. My name is Marie-Christie Yango. I graduated BS Business Management at USJR. I had my first master's degree program at CTU main campus, which is MABED. And right now I am about to finish my second master's degree program, which is master's in management, major in tourism management at USC. I also passed the certified tourism professional last 2018. So basically I have 2 years experience in the industry, and I am currently connected with CTU Danau as one of the faculty in the College of Management and Entrepreneurship for almost 4 years. And aside from that, I am also an entrepreneur. Thank you.
Personal growth. It was really an amazing experience because I learned a lot of things, not from other lecturers, also international lecturers from other Asian countries, and also it really helped me a lot, not only in terms of enhancing my skills, my knowledge and competencies in terms of business operations and strategies, but also it really gave me bigger picture of everything, especially collaborating with international universities. Now we really learned also what are their culture and their expertise in terms of business that we can also apply. One, we can also benchmark in our country. So not only to ourselves, but also to our students and also to our I'm also handling in the university the repertory sports generation in the university. So this opportunity will really help me also to collaborate with international companies, with international universities that will really expand my horizon also helping not only the micro, small, medium enterprises, but also that our income generating projects in the university where we are now really doing, really work hard that with this endeavor, we can really help improve the income generating projects for our university, and at the same time as a former university director for technology business incubations, that my incubators are the micro, small, medium enterprises somewhere areas, also with our radio program, that the business school and air. So this is really one of the opportunities that we as a faculty, as a business faculty, we can also really help us to share our holistic perception in the business because of collaborating and partnering with other international universities will really give us a holistic perception on how we can compete. Because nowadays with the advent of technology, there are a lot of inventions already. It's very competitive in the market. But through this collaboration, through this partnership, we are now going globally. So in this manner, our products and services now can be very competitive. So this is one of the avenues that we as a faculty, we really need to grow, not only in the local business environment, but also in the international arena. So I think this is really a good opportunity for CD and for the faculty to be involved in this very engaging, very informative, and very productive, fruitful engagement for all the participating international universities. Thank you.
Personally, I realized that I have not even begun to tap into my potential on a personal level. I now have a goal worthy of my dedication, energy, and talent. On the professional growth, on the professional level, I really had to make things moving and make things happen so that I can contribute value to the university.
The experience brought me to a higher level of maturity. It has brought me to a higher level of realization that our responsibility is no longer bound within our community or within Philippines or within CTU, but has already crossed borders towards globalization. The experience also made me realize that we need to keep abreast of the latest trends and issues about entrepreneurship in the international market, because we need to compete with others. We have to change our perspective towards education, because in our country, we condition the mind of our students that they will become effective and efficient workers, but not to become renowned businessmen.
Giving the chance to become one of the international lecturers of the ETU Net Entrepreneurship exposes me confidently to participate in joining this kind of educational activity in the international level, where I was also to meet different students from different colleges and from different countries as well. Thus, I am very thankful that I was able to get along with them during that time.
I think this time is really a high time for us to offer the Bachelor of Science and Entrepreneurship. Because even before with this international collaboration, we are already planning to conduct the Bachelor of Science and Entrepreneurship because in our college we're already hiring faculty to have a faculty with the expertise now, with not only in terms of the educational expertise and also the industry experience, because before joining the academy, we used to work in the industry for more than 10 years now. With all the right, we are really a hands-on experience with all the operation in the business in terms of marketing, operation, finance, and human resource management. So we are already planning how to offer that BSN entrepreneurship. Also, we came from Center of Excellence. No? I came from University of San Carlos, and also other colleagues. No? Came from other industry companies before joining the academy. So we have already a pool of experts that can teach, no, the four major operations in a business to be successful. No, they are the marketing, operation, finance, and human resource management. So that's why we already have the knowledge, the skills, and the competencies that we can share and impart to our students, not only local and international students. So, so that the bottom line is that for them, really want to encourage, really want to mold more entrepreneurs. Now gone are the days that we are really producing students to be employees. But now with this BS entrepreneurship, our objective is that we want to produce entrepreneurs. Because if we produce, if we are molding entrepreneurs now, when we are molding the students from first grade to fourth grade college, when they graduate already, they're already ready to make their own business because they're already equipped with the knowledge, skills, and competencies to do business. So that is really why we want really to produce more entrepreneurs, because if there are many entrepreneurs in our country, it will enable us also to make many produce many companies. So if there are many companies, many more job creation, job employment, and also many creative products and services that we can compete not only locally and internationally. And also we are already helping also this our stakeholders to produce the products and the services that they need, and then also it really help also more entrepreneurs, more companies, more job creation, and it really help the economic development of our country, because the business is really the driver of the economy. So that's why we really are really pushing Bachelor of Science and Entrepreneurship, because this is where our country, you know, that is really where the economic development of our community and our entire country, that we are able really to be to improve, you know, our economic development, to become our country very prosperous already and very competitive in the local and in the international business environment.
The appropriate term is not about, is it high time for us to offer entrepreneurship program in our university? There is really an urgency, and we really lag. We are behind our neighboring countries. Why? Because when we say entrepreneurs, they are actually one of the elements that create wealth for the nation. Because when we have more entrepreneurs, we address the socio-economic issues of, first and foremost, the illiteracy. Because when you have entrepreneurs, they employ. And employment would give actually that that opportunity for employees to put their children into school. So we minimize illiteracy. We also minimize criminality. Why? Because the more people employed by the entrepreneurs, the more the criminality would decrease, because they would no longer steal, they would no longer have those bad intentions to the community, because they have already something to feed for their family. We also address the socioeconomic issues on hunger, because the more people you employ, the more people can put food on the table for their families. So to recap my statement, there is really an urgency for us to offer this program, because entrepreneurs would create wealth to the nation, and at the same time, entrepreneurs would help the government address the socio-economic issues of our society. The unemployment, the underemployment, the illiteracy, the criminality, and the poverty alleviation.
Also, know so as to the offering of the Bachelor of Science in Entrepreneurship, for me it is very important, especially nowadays, know that the most of the business enterprises were very affected by these uncontrolled factors not in their operations, like the pandemic. So it's very important to really offer the Bachelor of Science in Entrepreneurship to teach the future or aspiring entrepreneurs, you know, especially the youths, to how to be resilient, especially on those factors that is beyond our control. So, and also, ma'am, it is also one way and part of kind of cooperating to the collective vision of our country, which is which envisions to have a competent global entrepreneurs. So there are also studies good with that from the Canada Foundation that they conducted in our country, wherein they found out that most of the entrepreneurs here lacks the aspiration to also to trade in the international market. So because of the fact that they also lack knowledge about the international standards, or specifically the export standards, that's why it's very important also, especially to us teachers, to integrate the lessons and the updated programs of our government, especially under the Department of Trade and Industry, for the youths to know that what are the programs that they could be one of the beneficiary. Like, for example, there is a YEP program under the DTI, the Youth Entrepreneurship Program, and there's a mandate for that, which helps the youths to and how to it's like a mentoring program, helping the youths and preparing their minds to embrace the entrepreneurship field or area. So with that, with the presence, because there are many programs that are existing now that needs to be taught to the students, at their age, for them also to be ready, especially in the sources of financing. I know that there are lots of programs in the government that could be helpful for them, and even encouraging the students to join the contests from the different agencies in the government, like from the AMAS, the DA, which gave grants to those who have their own kind of contest, like in business planning, like that. So it's important for us also to encourage them to join those different actual experience and programs from the different agencies of the government. So I think that would be all.
As an entrepreneur, I think yes, because we need to equip with entrepreneurial mindset, and it is very important. And because of that, we can really empower every individual or every potential student. If ever we will be having a course of BS entrepreneurship, So by that, we can have give them or provide them business management principles that can catapult everyone success, everyone to business success. And I think, ma'am, I need to check the person, ma'am Arlene Salak. I think she is right, because when we engage in entrepreneurship, it should start as early age, and it is better that also the DepEd could incorporate entrepreneurship courses in order to train individuals as early as possible. That's all.